Hi YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Illustrator Advanced course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Also, there's a link in the description for the exercise files. Those are free to download, so go and download those. All right, enjoy the video. Hi there, in this tutorial we're going to create this duotone effect in Adobe Illustrator, plus we'll do a kind of a halftone option over here as well, transforming this image into these guys. Now this is not an official duotone that you're gonna create separations and send them off to your commercial printer, it's more like the effect of duotone. Alright, let's go and learn how to do that now in Illustrator. Okay, so first up, open up duotone.ai. You don't need to use this file, but if you want to, it's in your exercise files. Why? Because it's got a pink background. And I've got some sneaky text over there. You might not have these fonts, so I've got two versions, an outline version and a one that has the fonts that you can go and modify to your own font. And one thing with this one, we've just got to make sure our document's on RGB. Some of the things we're going to do requires it to be RGB. If yours isn't, go to File New and just make sure it's RGB, or over here, File, Document Color, and just make sure it's at RGB. Let's bring in our image. So Command Shift P for File Place. And there's one in there called, I've got two options here. We're going to bring this JPEG in. It's called the Cathedral of Holy Trinity. It's an amazing church here in Ireland, in Waterford, and it just looks amazing as the main point that I've used it. So I'm gonna bring it in, right? And I'm gonna drag it out and we're gonna start working. Now, I could carry on with this. My problem is that I want the sky to be in it. You saw that first version in the intro. I didn't have a sky in it. So often I wanna kind of just, wanna trim all this stuff back. To do it, Illustrator just doesn't do it, okay? It's Photoshop's job. So I'm gonna jump to Photoshop real quick and just show you how to quickly remove, say, the sky. So I've got it open here. I'm gonna use this tool here. Okay, he's the magic tool, the quick selection tool. If you haven't used him for a long time, he's got amazing over the years. Watch this, gonna click and drag and just kind of click and drag the sky and amazingly got most of the sky. There's a few little issues, but nothing that's gonna hurt my job. Okay, and all you need to do is click on this option here. It says make a layer mask. Problem is I've got the kind of wrong thing selected. So all I need to do is before I click that button, go to select inverse. Now I clicked on this guy. Awesome. Now I'm just gonna save him. Save him as a PSD, and I'm gonna add the no sky hyphen, which I've already done. So I'm gonna close him down and don't save. So you might just tidy up an image a little bit in Photoshop. And because we're gonna kind of destroy this so much, you don't have to be too special about it. So now we're gonna go file place. And Illustrator is pretty good at just bringing in PSDs. There's no reason to save out a PNG or anything. Okay, I'm gonna bring him in. I'm gonna make him the right size. So it goes to edge to edge. Try to anyway, come on. All right, perfect. I'm gonna have him down the bottom. All right, and first thing I need to do is convert him into like a vector shape. Kind of gives us the kind of printy look. So with it selected, gonna go over here. It says image trace. It's up there as well. Okay, so I'm gonna click on it. And the option I want in this case, you might play around with a few different ones. I found it looks good just converting it to shades of gray, because then I'm gonna, because the duotone is just two colors, right? And so I'm gonna use the color of the background and a color for the church or cathedral. So I just want it to be black and white, and then we're gonna recolor it once it's finished its little thing. All right, so we're nearly there, right? We need to, it's quite cool already. I need to get rid of the background, you know. The background just appeared again, I know. So to get rid of it, grab the white arrow. Okay, at least it doesn't have clouds in it. I'm gonna click off in the background, white arrow, click on it, the sky, and just hit delete. Don't do that, undo. Before I do any of that, I need to hit the expand button. It's along the top here. Okay, can't forget that. Then, with the white arrow, click off in the background, click on the sky, hit delete. All right, so sky's gone. It's all kind of lovely vector. If I go to wireframe mode, it's pretty complex. But next thing I wanna do is recolor it. So we did recoloring in an earlier video. Same principle works here. Black arrow, click on the sky. I'm gonna go to edit, and I go to edit colors. I'm gonna go to recolor artwork. Actually, I'm gonna jump to this preset. So this is the exact same thing, except it's gonna kind of save some time. I'm gonna say a one color job, please. Opens it up, says this, click okay. And what we want to do is we want to change all of these gray colors to the new color, which is, which color? I'm gonna double click on this. Okay, and pick a color. What color do I want? A kind of a purpley color. Now what you might find is that it didn't quite do it. Grab the saturation down here, I find's easier. Okay, grab this guy, brighten this up a little bit. Cool, darken it down. All right, I'm missing about too much now. Maybe full on purple. All right, so once you've got your colors, let's click OK. And now all we need to do is kind of get rid of the white. You could do this, it's still a duotone, okay, using the white of the paper and these two colors, but it kind of looks nicer if I start playing with my blending modes. Now, because of all this detail here, okay, it's really hard to actually see. Now, the shortcut for getting rid of all those lines is, that's right, Command H, okay. You turn it back on later on, but for the moment, just turning it off, it's still there. But at least I can see what I'm doing. And in here, I'm just gonna kind of work my way through. I like darken, that's kind of cool. Good interaction with the background here. Yeah, just work your way through now and figure out which one kind of gives you the effect that you were looking for. I'm gonna jump back to darken. Okay, gives me that kind of traditional duotone look. Last thing we will do is just bring in that text. So I'm gonna zoom out, here he is over here. I'm gonna grab these two guys. I've laid this out already. You might hate the layout, you can go and adjust it. And the one thing I might do though is I need to be in front. So I'm gonna arrange and bring to front. Cool, one more thing we'll do. You saw it at the beginning, that half tone look. So I'm gonna grab my artboard tool and hold down the Alt key on a PC, Option key on a Mac. Okay, and what I'll do is I'll select this and under Effect, under Pixelate, where are you? Pixelate, there he is. Color halftone looks quite cool. You might have to undo, come back to this quite a bit. There's no preview. Click OK. It's going to give me the kind of effect I want. You might play around with it. Gives it the color old school newspaper. We've exaggerated it a bit. But yeah, it's kind of cool little exercise. Now that's the exercise we've done together. Now it's time for your exercise. Okay, so there's homework for this one. What I'd like you to do is I'd like you to find a monument in your town. Doesn't have to be a cathedral, it could be anything. I'd like to see it. Okay, so find something online, quick and easy. Find something in your local town, the kind of significant building, or it could be anything. It could be your dog. I'm happy with your dog. Okay, but I'd like you to play around with both different colors, different fonts, and play around with this kind of duotone look. And I'd like you to send me copies of it. Okay, so use the website here, okay, to post your projects, or you can send it to me, but actually, and send it to me. Send it to me on Twitter, I'm Dan Loves Adobe, and on Instagram, I'm Bring Your Own Laptop. So I'd love to see what you're doing, yeah, and I'd love to see a little bit about your town. All right, that's gonna be this for the tutorial. See you in the next one. Hey there, I hope you liked it. If you did, give me a thumbs up. It really helps out what I do. I've got lots of other stuff here on YouTube, so consider subscribing. Also, I wanna see what you made. Okay, so you're obviously doing something. Don't be shy, I'd love to see what it is. If you put it up on Instagram, I'd love to, yeah, for you to mention me, I'm Bring Your Own Laptop on Instagram. And on Twitter, I'm Dan Loves Adobe. Also, if you like my teaching style and you know you want more advanced Illustrator stuff, there's the full course, okay? It's on bringyourownlaptop.com. There'll be a link in the description. Also on Bring Your Own Laptop is there's a resources tab and there's a free cheat sheet in there, free, totally downloadable. It has all the kind of, we did the keyboard shortcuts and stuff for Illustrator. It's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer. It's awesome. All right, continue on. Bye now.